So it's been over 4 months since I made the first devlog on how I made Confused Box, which is an infinite runner game that runs entirely on the browser. And so since then I've received several questions and several suggestions concerning how I made parts of the game. And also since then I've made several changes to the game. And in this devlog I'm going to be taking you through my thought processes and some of the behind the scenes of how I made Confused Box. And hopefully I'll be sharing with you also the changes that I've made and how I transformed the game from the first iteration onto what you see in your screen right now. Let's get into it. And so to get the elephant in the room out of the way, let's tackle the most asked question. Infinite tile generation. So basically we will be stationary, but the tile will be moving towards size. So let's say this is the class where you're spawning the tiles from. Well, we will have an objects array where we'll be storing all the tiles, but then the magic happens in the createObjects method. So here we just create a bunch of tiles up front, give them a Z positioning using the I in the loop, push them onto the objects array and then add them to the scene. Then on the updates method, we will move them on the Z axis towards us and check if they are met. They are beyond a certain point behind the camera, and then we will spawn it back at a position in front of the camera. But that is not super optimized, especially when working with 3D models. And so to fix that, we only spawn the tiles on demand, and that is by having a separate array of unused box and a distance to which we want to spawn the tiles to. Then we replace the loop with something like this. So if we have something inside the unused objects array, then we use that instead. If not, then we create a new tile, and then we have a new method called the spawner. And in the spawner method, we check to see whether it is fit to spawn a new tile in regards to the distance which we had declared earlier. And so if the distance is beyond a certain point, then it is fit to spawn some tiles. And then finally we can call the spawner method inside the update method, and also add objects to the unused objects array when they hit the threshold that we had declared earlier. And that right there, that is the engine of the game, because everything from the coins to the tracks to the vehicles to the power-ups to the buildings, everything is spawned in this fashion. And so if all that went through over your head, I guess you can pause the video, maybe repeat it a couple of times, because the most important thing is just to understand how the code works. And so if you get to understand that, you can tweak the code to match your style or whatever you're trying to build. For instance, on tweaking the code for and adding some parameters, for instance, on the X axis, I get the vehicles and the coins so that they can spawn on either -1, 0, or 1, and the same for the power-ups, just for the Y axis. And so you kind of get the gist of how it works. And yeah, that's the engine, that's what drives the game. There's one catch though. I have added some offset to the tiles depending on the assets used. For instance, you'll see that there's more space between the vehicles, there's no space at all between the buildings, and there's definitely a lot of space between the power-ups, so you'll really be receiving the power-ups. And that coupled with some Blender assets that I made up the first devlog. Now it's time for the second devlog. And by the way, we have over 60 subscribers on YouTube, over 25 followers on Twitter, 2 Patreons, and more have been subscribing towards the Applied 3.js course over at applied3js.com. So I would like to take this opportunity to thank you all for the continued support. And to all those who have not subscribed, yeah, you know what to do. Hit it. Hit all of them. Yeah, except the dislike button. Hit them all. Hit them. Yeah.
Excessive hitting of the screen may lead to screen damage. Please exercise this with caution.
Moving on to the changes and enhancements. The first enhancement you can see is there are more assets and there's a curved doll shader. So let's begin with the assets. So a very short story. I discovered a legend called Catanius through another legend called Simon Dev. And on visiting his site, I got some free models of cars. And since I know my modeling skills suck, I just made little tweaks to them so that they can be compatible with my game. And so here is the time lapse. enhance the curve dual shader, and that is achieved by some few hacks onto the built-in 3.js material, and then testing for the distance between each vertex and the camera, and then bending them in that regard. And things barely work on the first try, so just have to tweak some few things here and there, see if it works. So here's the final code I used to render the curved weld effect. So I have commented out the curvature because I have implemented curvature for the specific tiles. So you can just freeze this frame and go through the code. I have commented it out so that it is easier for you to understand. The final enhancements are relatively simple, but they will go a long way in improving the user experience. So the first one is to change the fog color to match the color of the sky. That way, when the tiles are generated, they fade in smoothly rather than the harsh one that was there before. Secondly, I have made the cube to be rounded. Also made the heads-up display to have a background which is rounded and some icons. I've also made a little animation when you get the power up. So these rounded corners are better according to UX. And since I'm not very much a UX guy, I'm not going to try to explain any further. Well, thirdly, I have added a sound controller to turn off or on the sound. And then lastly, I added a counter before the game starts to give you a short time to adjust before the game starts. And that's it. Well, obviously more has gone into polishing and making the game to be what it is, and this has just been a simple overview of it all. Just to quickly update you, for those who have subscribed to my Patreon, I'll be posting the first iteration of this game just for you, so don't worry about that. But then I'm thinking of making a course, and I think this game might be among the courses. So for those two subscribers, you'll be getting the game, but I will pull it down for recording purposes. And so if you want to engage with me and also to choose which tutorials and courses you would like to see, you can follow me on Twitter, and of course you can also follow me here on YouTube. And then you can subscribe over at confusedbox.com to receive updates on what's currently underway. And so with that, I'd like to thank you for getting this far. I'm Gideon Shuja, creative developer, and this has been a DevLog on ConfuseBox. See you in the next videos, and as always, keep grinding. Bye bye.